And many ulama wrote, Mahabbatul Rasul bayna al-ittiba'i wal-ibtida. Love of the Prophet Muhammad between ibtida, between innovation, and between ittiba', imitation of the Prophet Muhammad. That's what a real Muslim is, trying their life to imitate the life of the Prophet Muhammad in everything that they do, in all of their affairs. Not that kufr and disbelief is carried out in front of your face. Innovations are carried out in front of your face. Disbelief, fisk, fujur, isyan, disobedience, ma'asi, in front of your face. And you sit at the back and you say that we are lovers of the Prophet Muhammad ﷺ. We are lovers. What type of lovers are you? Man ra'a minkum munkaran falyughayyiru biyadihi. Whoever amongst you sees an evil, change it with your hands. فَإِنْ لَمْ يَسْتَطِعْ فَبِلِسَانِهِ. If not with your hand, then with your tongue. فَإِنْ لَمْ يَسْتَطِعْ فَبِقَلْبِهِ. If not with your tongue, then change it with your heart. وَذَلِكَ أَضْعَفُ الْإِيمَانِ. That's the weakest of iman. And look at the mass portion of our clerics. Look at them. Look at the state of them in this country. You find all types of kufr, disbelief, evil practices. Just sit there at the back. Well, what can we do? What can we say? This is the environment at the moment. No one's going to listen to us. Is that what the Prophet Muhammad has done in his life? Did he do that? Just sit back, allow it to take place, and then you claim to be lovers? لَوْ كَانَ حُبُّكَ صَادِقًا لَأَطَعْتُهُ إِنَّ الْمُحِبَّ لِمَنْ يُحِبُّ مُطِيعُ. If your love was truly true, if you was devout towards your love, indeed lovers obey the one that they love. They obey the one that they love. Likewise, the Arab poet, he wrote these lines of poetry. كُلٌّ يَدَّعِي وَصْلًا بِلَيْلَى. Every single individual claims to love Layla. Layla in these lines of poetry is like Shakespeare's Romeo and Juliet. Everyone claims to love Juliet, but Layla doesn't recognize anyone. وَلَيْلَ لَا تُكِرُّ بِأَحَدٍ. Layla in these lines of poetry is the Prophet Muhammad ﷺ. On that day, he will not recognize you. Read the hadith on the Day of Judgment, that these people, when the Muslim Ummah will come towards the Prophet Muhammad ﷺ, come to his fountain to drink. Whoever drinks from that fountain will never become thirsty again. And people will be coming and saying, Ummati, Ummati, let my people come, let my nation come. Jibreel alayhi salam will stop some people. He'll say, why are you stopping these individuals? They're my nation, let them drink. Jibreel alayhi salam will say, you don't know, Ya Rasulullah, what these people done after you. The innovations, the khurafat, what they attributed to you, what they've done once you left this dunya. And he'll say to them, Suhkan, Suhkan, be off you wretched individuals. Away from my life. You lived away from my life, and today away from me. You will not be close to the Prophet Muhammad ﷺ. Man ra'ani fil manam faqad ra'ani. Whoever sees me in a dream has indeed seen me. Look again, the deception of these individuals. The criteria to be a real believer is to have visualized the Prophet Muhammad ﷺ in a dream. We believe that as Ahlul Sunnah, if you see him in a dream, indeed you've seen him. But what does this hadith mean? You don't know nothing about his seerah. You don't know nothing about his life. You don't live according to his life. You don't know al-Shama'il al-Muhammadiyya, as written by Imam al-Tirmidhi, about the Shama'il, the khuluq of the Prophet Muhammad ﷺ, about his life. You don't live according to that. And now you dream and you think that the Prophet Muhammad ﷺ came in a dream to you. Indeed, that's nothing, the devil that came in front of you. Because real ulama of Ahl al-Sunnah, they know you visualize the Prophet Muhammad ﷺ. Because the Prophet Muhammad ﷺ will never come to you in a dream and tell you to run parallel against the Sharia, as many of these people do. They say the Sharia, you ulama of Ahl al-Sunnah, you only know the Zahir, we know the Batin. The Sharia is specific to us. And this is no exaggeration, living amongst these clerics, growing up amongst these clerics, they say that openly. You are people who only know the contextual understanding. We know the batin. We have special regulations given to us. We are people who are close to the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. وَاعْبُدْ رَبَّكَ حَتَّى يَأْتِيَكَ الْيَقِينَ. Worship your Lord until yaqeen comes to you. Look once again how the devil deceives them. I've reached the level of yaqeen, of kashf. I've come in a state of ilham, of inspiration has been given to me, singing like whirling dervishes. Where is that from the sunnah of the Prophet Muhammad ﷺ? Hallucination, trances, making dhikr, taking the name of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Those people make ilhad. Call upon, وَلِلَّهِ الْأَسْمَى الْحُسْنَى فَدْعُوا بِهَا. Call upon Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the most beautiful names and attributes. Look how they sing and they chant the names of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and go into hallucination, go into a state of kashf. That this is how we remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Did the Prophet Muhammad ever in his life go who in his life? Bring me wallahi one narration, and I'll bend my back down backwards to any sheikh who says to me, the Prophet Muhammad in his life took the name Allahu, Allahu Akbar, and went into who. One narration, I challenge these individuals. Don't bring me narrations about the fada'il of dhikr, of saying La ilaha illallah, of saying Allahu Akbar, of saying Subhanallah, of saying Alhamdulillah, of saying La ilaha illallah. Don't bring me those narrations. Bring me one clear-cut narration from Bukhari, from Muslim, that the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam went into a trance whilst doing his dhikr. Bring one narration, challenge these individuals. Kazzabun dajjalun, liars. Liars, they are what they attribute to the beloved Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. That's on that day, we say to them, be off. You've got nothing to do with the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam in trying to defend his sunnah and to revitalize his life. They are not revitalizing his life. They are not the people of the sunnah. They are people of Ahlul Ahwa, people of desires, people of bid'ah, people of innovations, who strive and they spend their money. These people throw money on the floor upon the awliya. Throw money on the floor, you know for what reason? So they can come in secrecy and a sheikh says to them, you're forgiven upon my hands. Ya sheikh man anta awwalan. Who are you to say to a person, you've been forgiven upon my hands? That's what these people they say. Donate to my cause, I guarantee you a garden inside paradise. That's no exaggeration. Sit inside their circles and mix with them. I guarantee you a garden inside paradise. Ya Sheikh, you can't even guarantee what's going to happen to you upon your own death. You're trying to guarantee people a garden inside paradise. Well, maybe you're about to take that money for your own personal cause. For your own personal interest, you take that money. That you come and you make a tour in taking this money away. Qawlan wa zura. In mesmerizing the people and taking their wealth away and throwing your blessings upon them. And then even what type of foolish behavior that you find. That even to spit on the food, blow on the food and say, this is barakah. I've said it to them many occasions, Ya Sheikh, what is this barakah? You know the people, they want this, we give it to them. They want this barakah, so we give it to them. So they even acknowledge what they're doing is wrong. And look at their hallucinations. They say, look, we've got a strand of the beard of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. We've got a blessed strand of his beard. Even if you have a strand of his beard, awwalan, historically, can you prove that's a strand of the beard of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam? And secondly, even if it is, the relics of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam are only applicable whilst he's living. Whoever drinks his blood, that body will not touch the fire. His sweat smells of musk. That's what you find about the Prophet Muhammad whilst he's living. But once he's left this dunya, then you have this blessed strand that you claim that goes back to the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And look how foolish these individuals are. All I can do is laugh about these individuals. It may sound incorrect and they may become all emotional. They place the blessed hand strand in front of everyone. Then they start making dhikr. And you study the science of physics. Excessive movement creates friction. So the beard strand begins to move and they say, Allah! Allah, look! Even the beard is moving with the dhikr. What foolish individuals they are. The strand of beard, look, is moving with the dhikr that we're doing, enjoying the dhikr that we're making towards the Prophet Muhammad, towards Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You know, this is nothing but Catholicism, Christianity. Most of our Christian brothers gave up Catholicism, Christianity, to become Muslims, not to become grave worshippers. Go travel through the Muslim lands, rampant with grave worship. وَمَا يُؤْمِنُوا أَكْثَرُهُمْ بِاللَّهِ إِلَّا وَهُمْ مُشْرِكُونَ. Most of them believe in Allah, but they worship these graves. They commit associate partners towards Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. I've lived in Pakistan for many years. Let no man say to me, every 500 yards you find a grave there. Throw a rupee here, throw a rupee there. You even find a grave called the donkey's grave. The donkey's grave. Because this individual traveling on a journey, when his donkey died, he said, oh, my companions died, my friend died. He used to take care of me, he used to travel with me. I used to be in suhbah and companionship with him. The people around him began to get startled and marvel. What a great friend he must have been. So when he left that location and he came back years later, they built a great big mausoleum for him. And he went by, he said, this great big mausoleum, I didn't see this before. Why did you build this? They said, you know, there used to be this good friend, he used to take care of his friend, carry him, carry his luggage, take care of him. He said, you asses, you donkeys, that was my donkey that died. And you think that's an exaggeration? I saw a man walking naked on the streets with just his underpants on. They should say to me, you know this Baba, Nanga Baba? Eh, pawn ke Allah de call to see kiriya galla karde ho. Years later, when I came back, I said, where's Nanga Baba gone? You see that shit? See that great big mausoleum there? That's what we built for him. That's what we built for him. An elderly woman, you find suffering from an illness, from dyslexia, major dyslexia, would become hysterical. In front of my eyes, people would go to her and think revelation is coming to her to find out about what's going to happen to them. Is something good going to happen to me, something bad? This is currently still happening inside our lands. People rush to the graves to ask for the dead. That's no exaggeration, because I